Sometimes during the day, both the sun and the moon can be seen. We stand between them, between the light and the darkness. Everything has been combined in us, solar insight and night lacerations. Every human is the universe, with the deserts and oasis, oceans and streams, storms and lulls. The death of a human is the death of a universe. Though, the soul is immortal and so are humans' doings. And from the moment the apple from the tree of knowledge of good and evil was ripped, the thirst of this knowledge became immortal. That's how the idea for a painting came. Immortal doings, immortal souls. At the top, near vanishing ghost of the moon, are the wonders of the world. The pyramids of Egypt, the Colossus of Rhodes, the lighthouse of Alexandria, the Colosseum, the Great Wall of China. All sorts of man-made wonders. Some people claim that this has not been without aliens. And I remember the words of famous Spanish poet Garcia Lorca that the human imagination invented giants in order to attribute to them the construction of great grottos, and it never occurred to them that all these beautiful stalactites and stalagmites are the result of the tremendous work of a tiny drop of water. Human hands are capable of many things. Here is the bridge in San Francisco on the picture it connects the past to the present, where there also the aliens who constructed it. And what about the swallow nest and the Warrens of Palace, the Statue of Liberty and skyscrapers, the Sydney Opera House, the Eiffel Tower, the Big Ben, the Moscow Kremlin, the Notre Dame, finally, the Pearl of Flamboyant Gothic Vilnius St. Anna's Church, and a double-deck bus on the concrete bridge followed by a simply cement carrier as a symbol of labor. Human is capable of many things. People go down to a lower part of the picture from a concrete bridge. There are a lot of them, more than 400. Politicians, priests, composers, artists, actors, crooks and gangsters. Ordinary people. No, not ordinary. They are all workers. Politicians build the borders, fight for the selfish interests of their countries. People of art build a world, create the beauty, which is designed for all of us. The gangsters, what the point of talking about them? They make their money as they can. I was asked why I did not put the good people to the one side and the bad to another, it will be a harmony. I replied that we are all sinners, we have a lot of different things mixed in, as was written by Oscar Wilde. Yet each man kills the thing he loves, by each let this be heard. Some do it with a bitter look, some with a flattering word. The coward does it with a kiss, the brave man with a sword. Some kill their love when they are young, and some when they are old. Some strangle with the hands of lust, some with the hands of gold. That is why I put in the middle the priest who pray for our souls. Here I have gathered politicians from almost all countries. Here are two former presidents of the United States, Bush Sr. and Bush Jr. Here are Putin and Obama. Putin was asked whether he would rescue Obama if he was drowning. Putin answered that he would. Obama answered the same question the same way. They would rescue each other. Do we have enough courage to save our world, which is so similar to the apple? Will the world become the apple of discard? Two of my grandmothers have told me that Aivazovsky is my distant relative. I put at the bottom this great artist who has managed to understand well the soul of the sea element. However, this is not the most important thing in the picture. The women are placed in forefront here. They are mothers. They stand on the sides as guarding the future, past and present. Everything is directed to the future, to the children, who are frolicking in the bottom. My picture is about them. Together with animal cubs, puppies, fowls and birds, they enter into a new life. Someone said a wonderful phrase. Children are born angels, we make them human beings. What kind of human will they become? In the center, girls are looking at a picture from a Bible. The book is opened just at the place where Adam and Eve were expelled from paradise because they ate an apple from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. A little boy drops the apple and tries to reach it. Will he reach it? And if he reaches it and bites, what he will feel? Will it be the honey flavor good or the bitterness of knowledge? They say that children are now developing extremely fast. Will they be able to help our world, which is so similar to the apple? Thin thread and wobbly suspension bridge pave the way to the central figure, to another wonder of the world, a statue of Christ the Redeemer atop Corcovado Mountain in Rio de Janeiro. It seems that he embraces the whole world. The bridge of San Francisco looks so graceful. The concrete bridge where people walk and double-deck buses ride is strong. The small bridge to the statue of Christ is flimsy and shaky. We can all pray, all together, but everyone has its own road to God, and it's not easy. There is a lot to say about this painting. However, it's better to look into it, to see familiar monuments, familiar faces. The main thing is to see the light figures of women mothers and think about what awaits our wonderful beloved children. Will they be able to help our world, which is so similar to the apple? Do not rush to avert your eyes. Step just a little further and look just a little closer and better turn off the light. You will see another wonder of the world, perhaps the most important of them, the Madonna by Raphael, who descends to you with a baby in her arms, surrounded by dancing couples of love. Can that possibly be aliens?